Today we're going to talk about something a little bit different. We're not actually going to configure anything in the physical sense, but in the abstract sense, in the firmware. Someone today had a very interesting question. Essentially, they said that they couldn't set all five steppers up in Marlin firmware. So I'm going to show you how to do this. I'm just going to roll off the names real quick for these steppers. As I know them, I might get them reversed. It's your X stepper, your Y stepper, your Z stepper, your E0 stepper, your E1 stepper, your E2 stepper, your E3 stepper, and your E4 stepper. So the issue that he was running with was that he was only using X, Y, and Z. Then when he wanted to run five additional steppers in addition to his normal one, it turned out he can only run four by compiling. So I'm going to show you how to fix that problem. So what we're going to do first is we're going to go over to the Marlin page, or excuse me, not the Marlin page, the BigTree Tech page over on their GitHub page. So we're going to search for the board real quick here, and we're going to look for Octopus. And what we have here is the Octopus version 1.0. I believe it's 1.1, but for the sake of the tutorial, it doesn't matter. So inside of here, we're going to look at the hardware. And as you can see, we have a pins file. So the pins file, you can see that it's motor 0, which associates with the X stepper. Then we have the Y stepper, which is motor 1, and so on and so forth up to the 7th one. So we technically have five steppers that we can use for extrusion. So inside of Marlin, when he went to compile, I'll show you what happened. So I'm going to open up a fresh copy of Marlin 2.0.9.2. So I'm going to click on my downloads folder. I've already extracted it. So I'm going to open up the first Marlin folder, the second Marlin folder, then select the folder. So I'll show you what the exact problem was that he was encountering, and then I'll show you how to fix it. So first of all, we have to change our environment. So obviously the quick method is go to Marlin, go to source core boards.h. Inside here, search on Octopus. And inside here, we're going to copy the version 1.1 of it. And we're also going to note the actual chipset, which is STM32F4. That'll be important in a moment. So what we're going to do first is we're going to go over to configuration.h. We're going to search on motherboard, and we're going to set the correct board type. Then we're going to change the serial port to -1. And normally I would just compile right now just to show you it's okay. But in here, we can set the number of compilers, or excuse me, the number of extruders. So if I were to set this to 4 extruders and then click the compile button, I may or may not get an error, but first I do have to set the default environment. So let me do that real quick. So over here, you can see that we have to go find that folder. So down here, we're going to look for STM32F4. We're going to search on Octopus. And we're going to copy the first one we encounter. And then we're going to close out of there, go to platformio.ini, replace the environment so that we're on the right one. And then we're going to go back to configuration.h, and I'm going to hit the build button down here. Now this may take a few seconds to build. It may build without issue. If it does have an issue, we'll try building a second time. If that doesn't solve the problem, then we'll correct the first issue that we encounter after the second build. So in this case, we've selected 4 hot ends, and it's saying something about a temp sensor. So let's see. It's saying that we need to correct, in this case, we have 4 extruders. And for this instance, we're just going to do a single nozzle. So I'm going to remove the comment with a control slash. And then I'm going to hit compile again. Now, the other way to solve that is actually to set a second hot end thermistor, which is under thermistors. But in this case, we're going to deal with the single hot end. So in this case, it may or may not compile again, but we'll see if it works. I'm pretty sure it will. So he was able to do 4 no problem, but the next issue that he ran into is when he kicked it up to the 5th one. So I'll show you how that happens. So you go here, you change it to 5, and then you build again. Now, just so you know, there is a option for mixing. I'm not super experienced with that, but if you post something on my Discord channel, at least one person, maybe two, knows how to deal with it. So in this case, we have another error because now we've got actually nothing for a second, or excuse me, for the next extruder. There's no E4. So to solve this, what we're going to do is we're going to go over to source. We're going to open that up. We're going to go to pins. And then down in pins, we're going to find our chipset, which is STM32F4. Then we're going to find our board, which is right here, which refers us to the common pins. So we'll go over to common. And in here, we'll see the problem. So as you go down through here, you can see that there's a bunch of steppers right here. So they're enumerated in this case, motor 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. But if you look real closely, you can see E0 is motor 4, which if we go over to our workbench, what they're saying is motor 0 is this one. So that is being attached to the Z axis in some cases, or excuse me, motor 3 is this one. So 0, 1, 2, 3. So the fourth one's here. So the Z for the number 2 Z, which in this case we want to change, we can go back over to our desktop and fix real quick. So as you can see, the actual problem is up here. I went right by it. So to fix it, what we can do is this. You can copy or type in E0 or E4 if we want to number them correctly. So as you can see, it only goes to E3 here. So in this case, the easy fix is to change these Z2s to E4. Now, it will make your motors out of order on your board, but you can change the enumeration, and I'll show you how to do that in a second. I just want to show you that this will compile. So we've already fixed those. So this is now motor 3. So if we click on compile, it'll actually build and hopefully have no errors. So let's give this a second, and then I'll show you the way to fix it if you want to enumerate it the way you want. Meaning going motor 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And that's a really simple fix. And I have to thank my patrons and my PayPal contributors for motivating me to do this. I'll put some credits in the end of the tutorial for the people that helped make this possible. So as you can see, it compiled no problem. So if you want to enumerate these correctly, you can say this is E0. 0, 0, 0, and 0. And then you can change this one to 1, 1, 1, 1, and 1. And then change this to 2, 2, 2, 2, and 2. And then change this to 3, 3, 3, 3. And then the final one, after we fix this, will be 4. So it'll be 4, 4, 4, 4, and 4. Now, the thing you have to note about this is once you change these are only for your extruders. It may cause issues if you try and add an additional stepper up here, because they may point to something else. But in this case, we've set it up this way so we can use it. Now, if you want to add an additional y-axis, the process is similar to what was there for the z. You just have to change it around. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.